start by running through some of the breathing exercises. You should not be feeling any stress or pain when you're doing this. If you don't feel capable of doing some of these exercises, please consult the doctor first. But let's start with doing the breathing exercises. Okay, they are the precious set of eight, part one, sin, the eight golden jewels. A bit about the breathing exercises now. You should do these breathing exercises always first thing in the morning. The only thing you should do before this is get up, have a litre of boiled water that you've boiled the night before that's nice and room temperature now. I like a litre, some people say even up to a gallon. Then I drink a bit after the breathing exercises with my breakfast. But do this before breakfast. Pick a nice spot like this. It's nice and green and leafy and quiet. As early in the morning as possible. It's better to get up a quarter of an hour earlier, do your breathing exercises, than to have that extra 15 minutes of sleep. And you should do them every morning. You do it as many mornings as you can, but you should try and do it every morning if you possibly can. Loses its effect if you don't do it every morning. The first thing that we should look at is how we actually do the breathing. The type of breathing that we're doing is called natural breathing as opposed to reverse breathing. But with natural breathing, you can feel it just if you put your, there's my belly button there, if you put your hand around your belly button, as you breathe in, always through your nose is a filter system, you shouldn't ever breathe through your mouth. But here, breathe in from the stomach. Notice I'm not using the chest. You should look as if you're pregnant here, with your stomach expanding. Reverse breathing is where you use the chest and you suck in the stomach. This is more advanced and not the way that we do these breathing exercises. We want to do nice, relaxed, natural breathing in the morning. So breathe here from the stomach, out like this. I'm wearing nice, loose clothing, drawstring pants here. Shouldn't have anything that's restricting around your stomach so that your stomach can just expand and contract naturally there. All right, the first exercise is called scoop the stream. This works all of your shoulder area, all of your arms. It's a nice relaxing one to start. You start here, or you start with your hands by your side, and then your hands float up as you inhale. And then meet at the top. Okay, don't go like this. Okay, but your hand should meet at the top and your fingers intertwine with your thumbs in. Okay, and then your hand should be flat. From there, back down. Again, they should just meet. And then up to the nose as you inhale. Push down. It's called scoop the stream because of this movement. Let's have a look at that again. Breathe in. You should do that 8 times. This whole movement here, 8 times. You might see I sometimes lose count myself because you shouldn't be actually thinking about anything when you're doing this. You should just be concentrating on the breathing. So you might lose count. You can do more if you like. You can do less if you really need to rush in the morning, but you should really try and do it as slowly as possible. It should be as slow as your breathe-in breath. So from here, and your body should be totally relaxed. Shouldn't be tension, you shouldn't be going and pushing these hard and going and pushing them down. Your body should be totally relaxed. The more relaxed the better. You shouldn't be using any muscle. Your arms should just float up. Okay, that's called scoop the stream. The next one is called press the sky. This hand here goes on that buttock fold at the back. Okay, on both sides. Just where your buttocks start. From here, it starts flat, and it comes up. As it comes up at the same speed, you should be coming up on your toes, turns at the nose, comes up, and then is flat at the top again, and comes back down, and back to flat again. Let's try that again. From here, up, breathe in, now exhale. In, remember, keep the hand flat. You should feel it stretching on the wrist here, and you should feel it stretching up at the top there. This is working the acupressure meridians all the way down your body. And then, of course, obviously, you do it the other side. You should do four each hand. Okay, that's called lift the rock. The next one is called the archer. Now this one starts in what's called a half horse stance. The stances we've used up to now is feet together and slightly apart. Okay, about 20 degrees, 30 degrees apart. Here, feet now are parallel, two shoulder widths apart, and this is a half horse stance, and it's about this height. A full horse stance is with legs parallel to the ground, and we do that the very last one, the very last exercise that we do. But here, feet parallel and pull your bum in. Don't do it like this. Some people aren't quite as flexible. Just go down as far as you can, but a lot of people go like this once they start to do this stance. Pull your bum in like a dog with its tail between its legs. All right, so pull that in like this so that your posture is always straight. Don't bend the spine like that. All right, let's have a look at how we do this. Here, we breathe in, and now out. Breathe in. Pulling it back like an archer pulling a bow. This hand here should be 90 degrees. That finger up this way. The finger up this way. Okay, with the fingers pulled back. All right. Here, hand comes flat, you exhale, and then you inhale. Always remember, breathe from the stomach. This should press two points between the shoulder blades here, called the gates of Wind. It's believed that all colds enter the body through these two points in the back, and when you actually have a cold, or when you have a cold coming on, you'll actually feel soreness between here. That's when you should do these exercises morning and night, step them up. And you can always do extra archer because that works this. This boosts the immune system, works the legs, and works those two points between the shoulder blades. So it looks like this, it's called the archer. Again, four each hand, giving you a total of eight. You'll notice everything's in sets of eight. From here, when you finish the last archer, bring your hands here, and then inhale. This is called search the clouds, search the clouds. And what you're doing is bending back at 45 degrees to either side. You shouldn't feel pain in the back. You should be using the legs. Therefore, only go as far as you can. If you have back problems, please, again, talk to your doctor first. So from here, breathe in,
Exhale.
Breathing in from the stomach. This works your back, strengthens your back, stretches all the meridians on the front of the body there, gets the flow going. Again, in a half horse stance. That's called search the clouds. You can see why you're looking up at the sky searching the clouds. The next one is called lift the rock. Again, you start with your feet 20 degrees apart, posture straight, everything relaxed. Hands come together here in front, flat, thumbs in, breathe in, turn in front of the nose, then exhale, coming back exactly the same way. Okay, the next one is called touch the sky, press the earth. This one also works your back, works your hamstrings. Again, if you have any problems with your back or your knees or anything like that, please see a doctor before you do these. Here, hands in front, you stretch up and you inhale and go back as far as you can. Exhale. Okay, I have my knees bent. I'll show you this from the side in a minute. Inhale. Exhale. You'll find that's very relaxing when you come up like that. So it's inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Let's look at that side on. From here, stretch back. Okay, I've got my knees bent. If you're very flexible, you can do it with your legs straight. Press the ground. Okay, next exercise then is called Eye of the Tiger, and it was around before Rocky movies were on, right? Again, coming up on the toes, turning your head as you inhale. Look around as far as you can. Exhale as you come back. Inhale. Exhale. Do it again. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Again, as with all the exercises, four times either side, giving you a set of eight. Also, with lift the rock, also eight times, and also with touch the sky, press the earth, do that eight times as well. Okay, the very last exercise is called grasp the swallow's egg. The reason being is because you don't make a tight fist, you should be able to fit one finger in there, all right? And then this is a full horse stance, so feet parallel, go down till your legs are, now, when you start, you might only go this far. You should just start to feel your legs getting a bit stronger. This will strengthen your legs. But after about 6 months, you should be able to go all the way down, legs parallel to the ground, unless you're extremely inflexible. This will work on your flexibility, will help build you up. So you come all the way down, breathe in, exhale, and then this comes up to the shoulder from the side. Up, exhale, exhale. So inhale on the out, inhale on the in. Sorry, inhale on the out, exhale on the in. Inhale, exhale. Hit those legs down as far as you can. Once you finish this, you come up, you do the traditional Chinese bow, also this, is your thumbs are stimulating the sternum there, which is another acupressure point. Okay, you do eight. You do actually eight either hand, The best way to count is you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right? And that's the pressure set of 8. Let me just do some of those, show you some of those exercises from the side on. So here we have scoop the stream, which is the first one. Inhale. Exhale. Make sure it comes up underneath the nose. Okay, the second one then is press the sky, so it comes up, down, four times each hand. The archer. Look at your hand as it comes across. Look at your hand as it comes across. Look at your finger, the tip of your finger. Okay, then search the clouds, come back. The other side. Going back at 45 degrees, not straight back, but 45 degrees. That searches the clouds. Lift the rock. Touch the sky, press the earth, stretch back, go forward as far as you can. Eye of the tiger. And grasp the swallow's egg. Sorry, side on. Okay, so that's all the exercises there. Now.